advanced form of Hauser syndrome. I don't call it Stockholm syndrome anymore, because Hauser syndrome is even worse. When Fulani conquers, get you, they oppress you, wake up in the morning and you start loving them. I call it Hauser syndrome. Not Stockholm. Stockholm is too foreign, too Western. It's too mild. If you are close to anybody serving in the Imo State government, if you are close to any APC high-profile position in Imo State, you must warn them and warn them tonight. Corporal Sodema is holding our people in Comunicado. These are Biafrans, some of them with no link to IPOB, no link to ESN, nothing. Three pregnant women are in Imo State government house. It also has this very day. In detention, in our land, women born in our land, married in our land, three of them are pregnant, out of, it is over 700, he's saying it's only 400. They are keeping in government house. They think we will forget them, so they can slaughter them and sell their parts, as they usually do. He has surrounded himself with Fulani Janjaweed. They have come in the guise, including terrorists in the guise of army and police. They will know that these are the people they call repentance terrorists. As I asked the other day during my interview that some people have said is a landmark interview with Dr. David Masanga, I made it very clear that nobody anywhere in the world, including the British High Commissioner, can distinguish between a normal patriotic Nigerian soldier and a Fulani terrorist in uniform. Nobody can make that distinction. That is why they must all be regarded as terrorists, all of them, regardless of who they are. Because some of you have very shallow reasoning, and this evening, as I said earlier, we are trying to connect. There is a part of the brain that the other animals do not have. It is called the frontal lobe of the cranium. The frontal lobe is not the part of your brain in front of your skull. It is called the frontal lobe. That is where every critical thinking takes place in a human being. Other animals do not have it. Even if they do, it is not of the same mass. The quantity is not as that you find in human beings. We are reasonable people. And I want Oposo Adema to understand that he is holding people in Comunicado, holding them. You are not the law court. Cycle Fulani of Imo State, you are not a law court. You people claim you operate a democracy. You arrest people, you don't try them. Because you know you have no case against them. That is why you cannot present them before any properly constituted court. What you do instead is to hold people, to kill them extrajudicially, and then distribute their body parts all over the world in the name of profit making.
All right, my dear viewers, you have heard it from the ox's mouth. This is a clear video from Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, right from DSS custody. In fact, this guy is just too much. No one can stop him from talking. Despite still being in detention, Nnamdi Kanu is still carrying out his day-to-day broadcast, you know, still sending his messages and all that. He's unstoppable. He's unstoppable. He has said it, that he will never get tired of talking until the Nigerian government are ready to do the right thing. And that is it. No wonder they are after him. Out of all the Biafran leaders, Biafran agitators, he is the only one they are after. Why? Because they know that he's the only one that is ready to reveal the truth. He's the only one that is ready to tell the truth. He is the only fearless one. We have Wazirike there. We have the leader of BNL, you know, BZE, Onka, and so on. What happened to those people? Why didn't they go after those people? Why only Mazi Nnamdi Kanu? You see that? Despite all of that, Nnamdi Kanu is still passing his message. He's unstoppable. Look at the message he has just sent to the Biafrans. And what he's saying is the truth. Many people the DSS are holding incommunicado. Many people the DSS are detaining. Most of them have no single link or connection with the IPOPs. Most of them are not IPOP members. They're not IPOP members. Now, the county is saying it clearly that those people they arrested are not IPOP members. Even the ones that are IPOP members, Nnamdi Kanu is giving that order right now from detention that they should release them. They should release them because they have done nothing wrong. This man is ready to carry the cross alone. He's ready to carry it alone. You understand? No wonder. Time to time number. Buhari keep calling for negotiation, he keep turning it down. Why? Because he knows that Buhari have an hidden agenda. He knows he has an hidden agenda, and that he doesn't want him to succeed or achieve. Not until we begin to understand this, we will never get it. That is the truth. The truth is bitter, but not be told. Not be told. You see that? So, my dear people in the house, it is good we tell ourselves the truth. It's good to tell ourselves the truth. Because this people don't like hearing the truth. The moment you start telling the truth, they'll start coming after you. The moment you start telling the truth, they'll send DSS after you. This is how they frustrated the life of Melafia until the elder statesman passed out. Same they have started with Mbaka. You see that? So they don't like hearing the truth. They don't like people telling them the truth. Whether they like it or not, the truth will continue prevailing. People will keep telling the truth. Let them continue going after the innocent ones. They will get tired. I tell you, they'll get tired. And they must surrender. Whether they like it or not. Because Biafran Republic is a must-achieve republic. And IPOP is really pushing it. If there is any group that is pushing for the agitation, it is IPOP. And I concur with them. Alright, let me start hearing from you anyway to know what you have to say. Don't forget your comments are very important. Don't forget to bring them below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.